Hi guys, I just wanted to show you a few pictures I've made a couple of weeks ago with the GoPro Hero 7 Black. I've always been trying to capture some lightning strikes, and about 2 or 3 weeks ago I was successful for the first time. I mean, I had one picture, I think, even 1 week before that, but it was not a really nice shot, so I tried and tried again, and on June 26th I was a little bit more successful. And here you see the settings. I mean, of course I was using the time lapse, and when it was in the time lapse setting I was using the night lapse, which is the bottom option, and I was starting with 30 seconds shutter time and the rest automatic. You can see that here. Exposure time means shutter time 30 seconds, but after that, because there were so many lightnings, I went down to 15 seconds to avoid double exposure. Sometimes you have to really adapt this time to the amount of lightnings which you have. Just make sure that not more than one lightning is in one exposure. I mean, you can try with multiple exposures, some professionals are successful, but I think it won't really work, or it won't really turn out good with a normal GoPro Hero with standard settings. I will show you after that why. I mean, this thing looks good, but I have a really bad picture where I'm going to show you that you can have too much exposure. Maybe this is one. Yeah, I'm not sure if this is a double exposure. Could be. I mean, sorry, if you have a weak lightning, then it could work. Lightning in the distance and so on could work, but if you have too much light, then it will ruin. I mean, the second or third lightning strike will ruin the first or second one. So here you see, I mean, that's the time size of the file, f-stop rate, and the ISO speed, which is of course or was automatic. So here we see the single images. Yeah, that's the first one, and here we have the second one. Yeah, let's go back to the thing. This is actually one of the best shots, so I'm zooming in a little bit to show you how clear this picture is. I mean, when we full zoom in, of course, I mean, you will see some problems, but I mean, it's not bad. I would consider this quite good for a GoPro. I mean, this is not a DSLR. I mean, when you want to make superb lightning pictures, then you need a DSLR, of course, no question about that, but this is really good. I mean, it definitely surprises me. I didn't expect such clear pictures. It definitely surpassed my expectations, but this is one. I'm not sure if this was a double exposure or that was just a huge lightning strike. I think, as far as I remember, it was just a huge lightning strike, so it totally overexposed in this range where we had the lightning bolt, and I think it came down. We have like the intercoastal, which is connected to the sea. The open sea here is about just 200 or 300 yards away from our home, and usually lightning bolts hit this area, which is pretty close. The impressive, that was simply too much for the camera. The strange thing, it captured this weird thing. I really have no clue what that is. Maybe aliens? No, I have no clue. That was just mirroring something, but I have no clue why this isn't like just a dot or something like that. So maybe it was moving around, but actually there was nobody in the room at this time. So really super weird. I haven't seen this in any other picture. So this is really super weird. Yeah, so maybe you have an idea what that could be. So let's continue. Also not bad. Next thing, yeah, that's not so good. Simply exploded in mid-air. Yeah, here weaker one, or maybe double exposure or something like, yeah, not explosion, but I mean, it just hit the really thin cloud area, which totally got super bright. Yeah, I mean, yeah, maybe that's the best one. Could be, I mean, this is not bad. Yeah, I moved this to the side. Hold on a second, not very good. Yeah, anyway, so really good, quite sharp, quite a lot of details for a GoPro. Definitely was not expecting such a good picture, such good images, lightning images from a GoPro. If you ask me, I mean, before I bought one, I would have told you, no, forget it with a GoPro. I mean, I had made my experience with other action cameras. I mean, they were not bad, but definitely not as good as with the GoPro. Yeah, that's quite impressive. I mean, yeah, again, not DSLR style, definitely you can tell, but it is way better than what I was expecting. A really, really nice thing. So absolutely not complaining about that. And yeah, I mean, I don't have a DSLR at the moment. Simply too expensive to buy a really good quality one. Doesn't make too much sense to buy a cheap one for $500. I mean, if you want to make really good pictures, especially during the night, you need full frame. And yeah, that costs at least about $1,500, something like that. And then you need good lenses and so on. So I just have this super zoom camera, and I think it's impossible to make a better picture, lightning pictures, with that one. I mean, I'm happy with the Panasonic FC82. Yeah, if you're in my channel, you have probably seen these pictures. With the super zoom, I think that's 60 times, 65 times, something like that. Pretty impressive. But during the night, yeah, not so impressive. I mean, maybe on par with that, but I mean, the GoPro is much smaller. So if I have the chance, I mean, I have the choice to bring a really small camera. I mean, I have done this with a tripod, which is about 100 grams or something like that, and the GoPro really super lightweight. I mean, you can take the whole equipment, what you need for such lightning photography, in your pocket. I mean, that's really awesome. You can't do that with a DSLR or with super zoom camera. That's an amazing thing. If you want to go to an area, like maybe if you have even a motorbike or something like that, I mean, yeah, okay, could be dangerous in a lightning storm, but if you are not going too close, yeah, why not? So anyway, yeah, that's about it for now. I'll try to continue, but unfortunately, yeah, I'm living in an area in Florida where we don't have a lot of lightning strikes. It's rather rare. But I'll try to find some good shots, and if I find some, I will share them with you. Especially if I find other settings or something like that, maybe pro settings, I will definitely try that. I mean, these are automatic settings. Just I really made the exposure time to 30 seconds and then the rest automatic. Nothing to change, but maybe you could change something with the I don't know at the moment what you can change, but there are a couple of things which you can change with the GoPro. So anyway, I hope I was able to help you a little bit with that. If you have any questions or comments, just write to the comment section below, and I'm always happy to talk about these things. And if you like the video, give me a thumbs up, subscribe my channel. Thanks for watching, and see you next time on this channel.